So I was at a what do you call it? Kozen Vagongyo. We went back to Kozen Vagongyo. We called it World Peace Prayer. Now we're back to Kozen Vagongyo. We're going back and forth. So I still call it World Peace Prayer usually, but they call it Kozen Vagongyo again. And my piano teacher from Soak University and my recording teacher, Michael Golden, was their guest leader, doing final encouragement and a question and answer. I was like, "Oh, I'm gonna ask a question." And every time I was like thinking I was gonna ask the question, then bam, another person raised their hand. I'm like, "Damn, okay, I don't want to." They were kind of newer members, so I thought, let them have a chance to answer, qu ask questions. But I was thinking about this question for a long time. Ever since I went to Japan, and I talked about bodhisattvas of the earth, and then they would, a lot of people were like, "What are you talking about, bodhisattvas of the earth?" My translators that were SGI members, and they're like, So I thought of Bosatsu no Earth. I don't know the name for Earth. So I was like trying to like say to them, like, I don't know what that is. And finally I found one that was like, oh, it's Jiyu no Bosatsu. So Jiyu no Bosatsu is the son of Jiyu over the new land, which President Ikeda wrote back in the 90s. I had looked up that word, Jiyu, and I was like, oh, it means freedom in Japanese. And but I didn't realize that a bodhisattva of the earth in Japanese is Jiyu no Bosatsu, a bodhisattva of freedom. So I thought that was really strange that in English we call it bodhisattvas of the earth. Most people don't think of the earth and freedom synonymously. Is that the right word? I'm relearning English since I've been in Japan too long. Getting back synonymously. I think that's a word. Okay, look it up. If it's, I got it wrong, correct me. I know I got the supposedly and supposably backwards sometimes because I don't really give a dang. But anyway, so this idea of Jiyu no Bosatsu as Bodhisattva of the Earth, I like it way better than Bodhisattva of the Earth because, yeah, great. I'm come up from the ground of the Earth, so you're going to call me Bodhisattva of the Earth. No, I come up from the Earth dancing, total freedom. And what happens after that is they introduce this idea of the Buddha of absolute freedom. So in Buddhism, we have the oneness of everything, the oneness of that, and oneness of this, and oneness of that. Everything's like oneness because it's all I am he as you are he as you are me, and we are all together. It's all oneness. We are the oneness and consciousness of all things in Buddhism, if you want to get to the deep down mystical meaning of the Lotus Sutra and the Nirvana Sutra and the Threefold Lotus Sutra. Anyway, I'll do readings about that in the future. But so this idea of bodhisattvas of freedom. Wow, that is like so beyond the idea of bodhisattvas of the earth that I have. Because freedom, if the oneness of mentor and disciple, which is shitefuni in Japanese, is true, then we are one with the Buddha of absolute freedom. Otherwise, we wouldn't be bodhisattvas of freedom. So I was hoping to ask this question to Mike and Golden. I'm going to post him that next time he shows up at a meeting that I'm in attendance, I'm going to ask this question so he's prepared, because I didn't get a chance to ask him because we had a lot of people asking pretty interesting questions. Anyway, and he did well. He did a good job at answering all the very interesting questions. I don't know that I would have done better because they were interesting questions. Sometimes you get really interesting questions from really new members who have very interesting points of view, which I have a lot of very interesting points of view too, so don't. Just because I'm a longer time member doesn't mean that you get rid of all your interesting point of views, because actually interesting point of views make you interesting. And why not be interesting? Okay, so that's what I'm gonna discuss with you guys on my Facebook page. What do you guys think? Bodhisattvas of freedom, Jiyu no Bosatsu. Is that better than Bodhisattvas of the Earth? And how do you put these two incongruous ideas together? Earth and freedom, because Earth has been a, for the longest time that I've known, ever since history was written, it's been a land of slavery. Most people are enslaved by their cultures, their cultures, and they have to follow the person on top of their cult and their cult programming, and it still hasn't dissolved. I mean, we've gotten a little bit more freedom, but most free dumb, it should be, we're free to be dumb and vote for dumb people who do dumb things, and that's called freedom. That's called democracy, anyway. Which democracy and freedom don't really aren't even congruous. It's like military industrial complex, or military intelligence, or what else? Anyway, you know what I'm talking about, incongruous ideas. So the Earth, yes, the Earth as an entity, and it is an entity, you can call it Gaia, you can call it whatever you'd like, it has a consciousness, and anything that has a consciousness has the ability to be completely free. But it has to do some major tsunamis to get free of all the bullshit that we're doing to it. Some of us aren't doing bullshit to the Earth, because I'm gifting to the Earth every day, because I know how to gift to the Earth, because I am a Giono Bosatsu, and of the Earth, Giono Bosatsu. That should be it. The Bodhisattvas of Freedom of the Earth. Freeing the Earth from the slavery that humanity has wrought upon it for too many millennia. That's what should be the title of the Bodhisattvas of the Earth. Okay, so what do you guys think? You like Bodhisattvas of Freedom, like Japanese translation is? I don't know how it came in English as Bodhisattvas of the Earth when translations somehow went through China and then came to Japan. That's how they were translated, and it became Jiyu no Bosatsu, Bodhisattvas of Freedom. So in the poem Son of Jiyu Over the New Land, he talks about the stately, expansive state of Jiyu springing up, like springing up from the earth, like this huge treasure tower. And the ceremony has not yet dispersed. I'm kind of messing it all up because I haven't read it in a while. I should go back and read it before I make a video. Anyway, you can go online and read it. It's called The Son of Jiyu Over the New Land. One of my favorite poems by Daisaku Ikeda. A very long one, just like to you, my young American friends. If you're going to read to my young American friends, I would read the 70s version. I like it much better than the new 90s version or 2000 version because I don't like the translation. Anyway, I'm a little biased to the 70s feel, you know. Groovin' to the Carole King tune. Is it too late, baby? Is it too late? That's Feeling 1972 by one of my favorite singers. I forgot his name because I can't remember. I have too many favorite singers. Okay, peace out, ladies and peeps. See you next time.